gal down the road. John Williams opened the 1984 Olympic Games. We knew we were in for an athletic spectacular. But what we didn't know was that during those 2 weeks, we would rediscover some very important things here in America. Through our wonderful athletes, we discovered a feeling of pride that had been missing in this country for too long. And we also rediscovered the meaning of that simple word patriotism that had also been out of fashion much too long. So that by the time, 2 weeks later, when the wonderful music of Lionel Richie brought the Olympic Games to a close, it truly was party time all over America. I'm sure that long after we've all forgotten who won, who lost, who competed in those Olympic Games, there'll be certain things we'll remember for a long, long time. For me, it's going to be that moment in the opening ceremonies when a young lady from Los Angeles, supermarket clerk, picked up a microphone like this one, stepped out in front of 2.5 billion people all over the earth, started singing a song with a simple message of brotherhood. Suddenly you noticed that the athletes on the field had joined hands and were swaying along with her. And then almost 90,000 people in the stands stood up and started singing along. It was a wonderful moment. We'd like to share it with you tonight. We'd like you to share it with us. May I introduce to you, from Roanoke, Virginia, Miss Toni Mitchell. Thank you, Toni. That's wonderful. Ladies and gentlemen, you are fantastic. Let me tell you, I think we ought to record that number with you, do a music video of that. There's only one thing, and after an experience like that, I really hate to seem critical, but it is important. You see, while some of you were leaning this way, I see you noticed. Others of you were leaning this way. See, our choreographer is in the audience. She wants to have everything together. But you know, that does point up something really important. Here in America, no matter which way you lean, we all get along together, right? Don't you believe it if anybody tells you that nostalgia is not what it used to be. All you've got to do is look at what's happening on Broadway these days. There are more revivals of old shows than there are successful new shows each year. And some of the new shows are put together out of older music. Yubi was a show like that, music of Yubi Blank. And of course, Sophisticated Ladies, very successful, wonderful show, was built around the music written by Duke Ellington back in the 1920s, 30s, and 40s. We'd like to share some of the music from Sophisticated Ladies with you tonight. A couple of songs you might not have heard before. But first, just to set the mood, we're going to turn this place into a nightclub right now. And recall a different kind of nostalgia. A young lady named Linda Ronstadt started out as a country star and lately has made a whole career out of singing some of the beautiful old ballads. Well, tonight, I'm going to introduce to you a young lady who will sing one of those ballads for you tonight, and in about a week and a half, we'll be leaving for Busch Gardens, where she will spend the summer as a country singer. And it goes around in full circle. So if you will direct your attention, right down here, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Laurie Saunders.
Down my resistance.
Danville, Virginia. We'll be hearing more from Lori later on in the show. You know, when you hear old songs like that, different styles and so on, it kind of gets you to thinking, what is it that gives the song a certain quality that puts it on the charts, puts it in the top 40 and so on? A couple of months ago, I got to wondering that because a song showed up on the country music charts that was not your normal kind of country song. You know, it was not about love or trucks, any of the usual things. Instead, this song was about a squirrel. Well, tonight, the magical voice of Brian Lehman with the orchestra and chorus, we would like for you to enjoy the ballad of the Mississippi Squirrel.
Well, when I was a kid, I'd take a trip every summer down to Mississippi to visit my granny and her antebellum world. I'd run barefoot all day long, climbing trees, breeze a song. One day I happened to catch myself a squirrel. Well, I stuffed him down in an old shoebox, punched a couple of holes in top. When Sunday came, I snuck him in the church. I was sitting way back in the very last pew, showing him to my good buddy Hugh, when that squirrel got loose and went totally berserk. What happened next is hard to tell. Some thought it was heaven, others thought it was hell. But the fact that something was among us was plain to see. As the choir sang, "I surrender all," the squirrel run up Harv Newman's coverall. Harv leaped to his feet and said, "Something's got a hold on me." Yow! The day the squirrel went berserk in the first self-righteous church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula.
this year, as we have done every year, we have attempted to do every year, we have produced a brand new record album and tape that has on it this year's music, this year's soloists, singers, band, and everything, and you will find them out in the lobby during intermission and after the show, if you would be interested in taking part of this show home with you. Now, I say that in every show, but tonight, this weekend, we are going to do something very different, something we have never done before. It's an experiment, it is a challenge to you, our audience, and I'm going to tell you what it is. We did this last night. We're going to see which audience this weekend is going to be the best. A lot of people ask me if we plan to put We Are the World into the show. Of course, it's a wonderful song, and it was recorded for a wonderful cause by USA for Africa. But the more I thought about it, the more I thought, now wait a minute, if we were going to do the song, we'd just be taking advantage of what they have already done. What can we do? What can the new Virginians do that would really mean something to the people in the cast? So what we're going to do is this. Have a little contest using our own recording. If, I'd say we've got about 2,000 people in here tonight. If, during intermission and after the show, more than 120 of our albums and tapes are sold, and if it's more than last night's audience bought, then the New Virginians, on behalf of you, our audience, is going to send a check for the entire profit of that night on those records and tapes to USA for Africa. So it's up to you, folks. Do good. And I don't think we'll have the figures and know at the end of the show. If we do, I'll let you know how it came out. We are observing quite a few significant things in our show this year, paying tribute to things like the Olympics that have happened in the last year. And we are paying tribute also to a man who has been very special in American music. His name is Fred Waring. He passed away last summer at the age of 83 after devoting an entire creative lifetime to helping choral singing become as popular as it has been in America. The New Virginians, any group like this, would not exist without Fred Waring's work. So in tribute to him, and to bring back and enjoy again some of the songs that he did so much with, we are doing some of his songs tonight, beginning with one particular one. Now, the New Virginians, as you may know, started as the Virginia Tech Men's Glee Club. And Fred Waring's Pennsylvanians also started as the Men's Glee Club. And as they toured around the country, one song in particular was so popular, everybody waited to hear it in their concerts. If you would care to check the reference on this after you go home tonight, look in the book of the prophet Ezekiel, chapter 37.
You'll cry,
dry bones, easy, you'll cry,
dry bones,
easy to cry,
the dry bones down here, the word of the Lord, easy to your connection, the dry bones, easy to your connection, the dry bones, easy to your connection, the dry bones down here.
Carrie Edwards. concert Fred Waring conducted over a long lifetime, he always made sure to show off the various soloists in the group. And of course, as you've already recognized, we do exactly that with the New Virginians too. And for, I guess, more than 40 years, he had one particular song that he used to show off his low bass. Well, I'd like to use that song, and I'd like you to meet our low bass from Virginia Beach, Mr. Paul Lawson.
Theme song was commissioned as a gift to Tech from the class of 1943. The man that they asked to write it was none other than Fred Waring. It's very interesting because he was not known as a songwriter. The only other song I know of that he did write was his own theme song. But he did write one for us. It's a beautiful song. We are proud that he wrote it for us, and I'd like you to enjoy the new Virginians version of Moonlight and VPI. Close our tribute to Fred Waring, to close the first half of tonight's concert, there is no other song to pick than the one that Fred Waring and the Pennsylvanians sang for more Americans, inspired more Americans, especially during those uncertain years of World War II, than any other, the battle hymn of the Republic.
Traveling out the vintage where the brave soul. Ladies and gentlemen, there will be a 15-minute intermission. Records and tapes of the Great American Variety